Hello all of you, welcome to Sanmugam IAS Academy. I welcome you all for current events of the day. Let us take up the topics for today's discussion. A drone delivery of COVID-19 vaccines, scheme for special assistance to states for capital expenditure, quality standards for four spices has been finalized, launch of Operation Samudra Setu 2, how to prevent third wave of COVID-19. Okay, let us take up the first one, that is drone delivery of COVID-19 vaccines. Because of this increment in the COVID cases in India and Tamil Nadu, in so many states of India, the government, the Ministry of Civil Aviation, has planned to implement a new project called drone deployment of the vaccines. So vaccines nam vandu drone moolama delivery panna porom, ena through this we can avoid the spread of COVID-19 and we can surely stop the spread by mutual contact of each and everyone. So the permission has been granted within visual line of sight range using drones. So drones vandu yaar use pannalam adukana license irukku. So based on that method they are going to use this drone delivery project. It is a valid one and it is only for the period of 1 year or until further order comes. Earlier this month, similar permission was granted to the Indian Council of Medical Research for conducting feasibility study of COVID-19 vaccine delivery using drones in collaboration with Indian Institute of Technology, IIT, that is Kanpur, which is located in Kanpur. So, vaccine delivery and improved healthcare can be accessed by this method because they are going to deliver these vaccines at the doorsteps of the citizens. Limiting human exposure also and one important point, and we can also serve to the areas which are very much remote to be contacted. It can improve the medical supply chain because this is a new method which is expected to be increased across the India. And the next one is about scheme for special assistance. So our central government, that is Ministry of Finance, has planned to give 50,000 crore, that is 15,000 crore to states as interest free for 50-year loan to spend on capital projects. So states ku center vandu enna pandranga 15 crore rupees madhipulla panatha kuduthe capital projects vandu adhigam pannunga, capital expenditure adhigam pannunga appadine they are assisting. In the name of the scheme called Scheme of Financial Assistance to States for Capital Expenditure for the financial year of 2021-2022. Under the scheme, financial assistance is provided to the state governments in the form of 50-year interest-free loan. So, in the panatha, central government, state government kudupanga, but state governments are not asked to pay back the interests. 50 years use panita and the panatha thirupi kudukanume thavara and the loan vandu they have to pay without interest. An amount not exceeding 12,000 crore was earmarked for the scheme for the financial year of 2020-21 and some of the 11,830.29 crore was released to the states. So this is how this program is being implemented by the Ministry of Finance. This scheme has been implemented by Ministry of Finance of Government of India for the assistance of states. So they are going to implement this special assistance to the states in various parts. It is up to three parts. The first one is about supplying to the northeast and hill states, and again the second part which consists of the parts which are included in the which are not included in the first part. So part 1 is totally different from part 2 and part 3. So just keep in mind it is a centrally sponsored scheme. It is not a state sector scheme. It is a centrally sponsored scheme by the Ministry of Finance. And the next one, quality standards for four spices finalized. So I have discussed it in the earlier sessions. Spices, we are importing some of the important oils from another countries like Malaysia and other countries in South Asia, but we are a good exporter in the spices. in the primitive years also, we are being as a good exporter of the spices called cloves, oregano, basil and ginger. So it has been finalized in the 5th session, which has held recently by the committee called Codex Committee on Spices and Culinary Herbs, that is CCSCH. So even though they conduct pandranga, they are going to implement these standards for the export of these spices. New work items were also taken up to develop codex standards for small cardamom and turmeric, and to develop the first group standard for spices that fall under the class dried fruits and berries. So these all are the things which has been classified the spices as dried fruits and berries. It is an youngest of the codex committees, commodity committees. This committee is chaired by India. The spices committee board is also present in India. The secretariat also there in India. The mandate of this committee is science-based quality standards to be given with the culinary herbs which are being produced in India. And this codex principles will consist of the production of consumers and fair trade practices. Next one is an important one, that is launch of Operation Samudra Sedu 2. So we have know what is that Samudra Sedu 1. So if you are not knowing that, please refer it. It is also an important one. Indian Navy is going to start this operation called Samudra Sedu 2. It is an ongoing national mission for meeting the oxygen requirements. So because of this increment in the COVID cases, it is increasing day to day in each and every state of the India. So to control this, the pre-plans are very essential, but this pre-plans has been a failure in India, so that we have saw an disastrous demises of people in India. So most of the people are being affected with COVID-19. So we have to treat them with the required medicines and the oxygen supply. So the people who are being affected with COVID-19 mostly lacks this oxygen. So respiration process is being totally affected. So we are not having these plants of production of oxygen. Now we are importing this oxygen from various countries. So we are going to implement this project called Samudra Sedu 2 to require and procure oxygen from various countries who are willing to give oxygen supply to India. So we are having these two ships called INS Kolkata and INS Talwar, which have entered to the port of Manama, Bahrain, for embarking and transporting 40 million tons of liquid oxygen to Mumbai. So that is only the point here to know and have in mind about Samudra Sedu 2. INS Jalsaswar is en route to Bangkok and INS Aravat to Singapore for similar missions. Last year, Indian Navy has launched Operation Samudra Sedu as part of the Vande Bharat mission and repatriated about 4,000 stranded and distressed Indian. So it has taken those Indians who has been left out from India in some other part of the world, has been rescued. So there has been the Indian citizens from Maldives, Sri Lanka and Iran. So in the mission they have rescued, called Vande Bharat mission. And the final one, that is about how to prevent third wave of COVID-19. So it is also an important thing, because in day-to-day life, in this 2021, which is a new year for us, and it has crossed about 3 months, 4 months from today, but still we are lacking this control over the COVID-19. So what we have to do exactly? So this article is totally saying about what we have to do day to day. So mass vaccination is essential as per this article. It is to prevent a third wave of a COVID-19. Measures such as masks wearing, physical distancing and hygiene need to adhere. So these are all the important three things which has been repeatedly told by the government. So each state and union territories and the central government is also saying about everyone should have this mask, everyone should do this physical distancing, everyone should be hygienic. So these are all the awareness which has been created. So even though these all are there, but still we are lacking this decrease or decrement in the cases of COVID-19. So let us discuss. High possibility of third wave is also there in India, because India has not followed some of the measures which has been taken by the countries like China, South Africa, and countries of South Africa, like, and countries of South America has also done some new things to prevent this spread of the virus. So this measures has not been eagerly taken up by the India, and it has not been noticed by the Indian government. So how the possibility of the third wave can be prevented? First, we have to supply the mass vaccine is the right option, and we have to create herd immunity, and it will bring the pandemic under control. Herd immunity is the immunity which will be created through the supply of vaccination to the particular people or particular area of people in India. So we have to start in a time duration, slow pace of vaccination, inelastic vaccine supplies, limited finances with state governments. How to persuade people to wear masks? So we have to do this process, because it is one important thing to wear masks and use hand sanitizers. Providing free masks will also encourage the people to have or wear the masks. And we have to improve the quality of the masks to make people wear in both seasons, like summer and winter. It should not create any itchings or irritations. Reminders from religious and community leaders and volunteers is essential, because it will create an awareness among the people. How India can replicate this model to nudge mask wearing? Big India have supply its mask in a low cost, so that people will have the eligibility to get the mask or buy the masks. So that government have to allocate some amount of money in the budget to produce the masks. So mask produce பண்ணுற கவர்மெண்ட் என்ன பண்ணும், they have to spend some amount of money from the budget to produce the mask. Second, it should create communication campaigns. Communication campaigns in the sense, they should not make crowd of people to preach them. They have to tell with social distancing, they have to provide masks, they have to give gloves, they have to give this immune creating drinks. So likewise, this mass campaigns and communications will reduce effectively the spread of COVID-19. And thirdly, community levels have to participate to encourage the networks of health workers and the villages. If the country is to reduce the impact of future waves, it is essential that above measures are put in place. So these are all things that the government must have in mind and take into action to control the spread of mass COVID-19. So with this, we wind up today's session. Let us meet you on tomorrow's session. Thank you for watching.